Hello everyone. So let's continue with estimation class 3. In this class we'll be learning about steel and we'll also be solving previous gate problems based on estimation. So steel is nothing but an alloy of iron and carbon. Alloy means when two or more materials are combined to produce new material with better properties are known as alloy. So maximum carbon content in steel can be up to 2%. So there are two types of steel, structural steel and reinforced steel. Structural steel is denoted by E and it is also known as engineering steel. Grades available are from E250 up till E650. Structural steel are mainly used for construction of tall building, that is lightweight construction. But the backdrops of structural steel are that they fail only due to corrosion, because they are more exposed to air and oxygen and less fire resistant. For example, in World Trade Center, structural steel was used as for lightweight construction. So when the incident took place at World Trade Center, the structural steel could not withstand the temperature and the steel columns melted and therefore the building collapsed. And the second type is reinforced steel, denoted by Fe. Fe stands for iron. We have four basic grades. Fe250 is known as mild steel. Rest of the three, Fe415, 500 and 550, are known as HSYD. Also nowadays Fe600 are being used. All these types depend upon the amount of carbon content in them. So steel basically has the property of ductility, which means steel can be drawn into wires. Steel also has the property of malleability, which means they can be drawn into thin sheets. So ductility, which means they can be converted into wire. Wires combined together give me strands, and strands combined together give us tendon. Also there are cables and bars. Okay. So there are various types of sections which are used in construction, like T-bar, L-angle, hollow section, wide flange. Now horizontal is known as a flange and vertical is known as a web. Okay, we'll be studying detail about these sections when we go to the structures part of the exam. So density of the steel is 7850 kilogram per meter cube. Steel is always estimated in terms of mass, in terms of kilogram or ton. So whatever previous gate questions we'll be looking about steel, always the steel quantity is asked in terms of mass only. Okay, so this was all about steel that is required for estimation. If I feel somewhat more content is needed, I'll definitely upload a video. So we'll be solving the previous gate problems based on estimation. So the latest one was asked in gate 2020, where a sloped footing was given and we had to find the concrete needed in volume in meter cube. Okay, so I have classified into three basic volumes: red, blue and green colored volumes. Red is the basic rectangle, which is the base. Also the dimensions are 2.5 into 2, so area is 2.5 into 2, and volume is multiplied by its height is 0.4. okay, similarly for the blue part, volume is area into depth. Area is 0.4 into 0.5, and volume is nothing but area multiplied by its height. Height is 1.1 plus 0.5, height is 1.6. okay, and the total volume comes out to be 0.32 meter cube. And when we consider the sloped part of this footing, there are two trapeziums. This trapezium and this trapezium are equal. This trapezium and this trapezium are equal in volume. So considering the first type of trapezium, okay, the sides are 2 and this is 0.4 and its height is 1. How I got this one is 1.25 minus this 0.5 is 1. Okay, so area of trapezium we all know, it's half into sum of parallel sides into height. So After multiplying this area with the height 0.5, I get the volume. Now, when I multiply the height as 0.5, I will get the area of this box. Okay, but it is in sloped condition, so I have to divide this by 2. Similarly, goes for this trapezium. So instead of dividing by 2, I let the answer as it is. So the same goes for this trapezium also, half into sum of the parallel sides into height. So the volume is 0.6. So when we add all the four volumes, we get the answer in meter cube. So this was an easy question. It takes lot of time to solve this type of questions, so you have to be extremely fast in basic calculations. So the next question was from GATE 2019. So let's read the question. A power shovel having an 1.8 meter excavation per batch of operation. So once the power shovel operates, it gives me 1.8 meter cube of soil. Okay, average cycle is 45 seconds. So for one operation, it takes 45 seconds. The lost time per hour of the excavation activity is 10 minutes, which means for 1 hour of excavation, we lose 10 minutes. Okay, assuming 6 hours of operation per day, the amount of soil excavated will be. For 1 hour, 10 minutes is lost. Therefore, for 6 hours, we will lose 60 minutes. Okay, which means 1 hour is gone. So we are effectively working only for 5 hours. So 5 hours is nothing but 5 into 60 into 60. That is 18,000 seconds. And each cycle is about 45 seconds, right? So dividing these two, we will get the number of cycles. Okay, number of cycles will come as 400. Okay, so in one batch of excavation, I am getting 1.8 meter cube. So for 400, I'll get 400 into 1.8. That's nothing but 720 meter cube is the answer. Okay, if you have any doubts regarding this question, please let me know in the comment section. So the next problem is also from GATE 2019. This is a problem involving prismodel method. I'll give the answer in this part, but for prismodel and trapezoidal method of excavation, I'll be making a separate video also. Okay. So here there are three contour areas given, like 6 meter square, 24 meter square, and 96 meter square. The interval between them is 1 meter. We have to use prismodel method and find the volume of earth to be filled. So it is an depressed land, and we have to estimate the volume of soil which is used to fill this depression. Okay, prismodel method is 1 by 6 into L into area 1 plus 4 times area 2 plus area 3. Okay, now substituting this value, we'll get take L as 2 because interval is 1 plus 1, which is 2. Okay, so substituting A1 as 96, A2 as 24, and A3 as 6, we'll get the answer 66 meter cube. Okay, I'll definitely be making a video for prismodel and trapezoidal method. So it's easy only. We'll also be solving problems which are beyond the scope of GATE, so that you answer it, you know it better. Okay, now this question is based on my first video, which is about cement. So in India, for 1 meter cube of M20 grade concrete, the number of cement bags required are, see, cement packs, which means dry volume, which means we have to use the factor 1.54. okay, so M20 grade concrete is nothing but 1:1.5:3. Total it gives me 5.5 parts. okay, 5.5 parts, but cement is 1 out of 5.5 parts into the magic factor 1.54, rather call it dry volume factor. Okay, it will give me 0.28 meter cube, which means if I use 0.28 meter cube of cement, I will get 1 meter cube of concrete. Okay, but they require the answer in cement bags, number of bags. So multiplying 0.28 with its density, that is 1440, I will get the answer in kilograms, that is 403.2 kilograms. Okay, now one bag of cement is for 50 kg, so 403 kilograms means I will require 8 bags of cement to produce 1 meter cube of M20 grade concrete. Okay, now 1:1.5:3 is cement is to fine aggregate is to coarse aggregate. So let's move on to the next question. Similarly, this question is also based on the cement here for making 10 meter cube. Okay, the M20 grade concrete we require, but the ratio is given as 1.52. Okay, so we have to calculate the cement in meter cube, which is in volume. How much volume of cement is required for making 10 meter cube of M20 grade? M20 grade is 1:1.5:3, so cement will be 1 out of 5.5 into 1.52, okay, which will give me 0.276 meter cube. So now 0.276 meter cube will give me 1 meter cube of M20 grade concrete. But in question, they are asking about 10 meter cube of grade concrete. So I simply multiply this value by 10. So the answer is 2.76 meter cube. So 2.76 meter cube of cement will give me 10 meter cube of M20 grade concrete. Okay. So moving on to the next question. This is a bit tricky question. So I have used SketchUp in order to make it more illustrative. The site dimensions are given as 30 meter into 40 meter. The site has an unidirectional slope of 30 degree with horizontal along its longer side. This is the main part, with horizontal along its longer side. So the longer side between these two is 40. So 40 is in this side and 30 is in this side. Okay. Using cut and fill method, the amount of earth to be excavated so that site can be leveled parallel to the horizontal plane. Now this line is the horizontal plane. Okay, so we have to excavate the earth so that the land gets parallel to this horizontal plane. Right now it has a slope of 30 degree. Okay, so while seeing it in elevation is somewhat like this, with this side as 40 meter and this is 30 degree. Okay, now it is basically a triangle with height h. Okay, first we'll have to find this height h. So we all know that tan theta is nothing but opposite upon adjacent. So tan of 30 degree is opposite side is h upon adjacent side is 40. So solving for h, we will get h as 23 point something. So when we find the area of this big triangle, it's half into base into height. Okay, area is half into base into height. So half into 40 into 23 point something is the area of this big triangle. Okay, now this big triangle is composed of four triangles of equal areas. This is 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so this orange one is the fourth one. So So there are four equal triangles which comprise this big triangle. So when we excavate this fourth triangle, okay, and put this in the opposite direction, the site will be parallel to the horizontal plane, okay. But we know the area of bigger triangle, okay. So when we divide the area of bigger triangle, we will get the area of orange triangle, okay, because all four are equilateral triangles, okay, they have equal areas. So after getting the area of orange triangle, all we have to do is multiply by this length, that is 30 meter. So this area of triangle will be excavated all up to its length so that we get the volume of soil to be excavated. So this area multiply by 30 will give me the answer, okay. So such type of questions require a lot of understanding. You should be very calm and composite while reading the questions in the exam, okay. So next we'll carry on with GATE 2016. So the first question is, the estimated number of bricks, unit size is given 215 into 125 into 75 mm, and for laying 250 mm thick brick wall using rat trap bond for a learning length of 3.9 meter. See, rat trap bond consists of a void, okay. Rat trap bond is basically used to trap the heat, okay. So where areas have high heat persistence, rat trap bond walls are used. So as you might have seen in my brick video, that is video number 2, we have started with brick laying positions, that is stretcher, header, shiner, roll up and soldier, sailor. So in rat trap bond, basically the faces are shiner and roll up, okay. Now they have given the thickness of this wall is 250 mm, so this thickness of the wall is 250 mm thick, okay. Also the shiner face, that is this face is 250 mm, and the roll up face, that is this face is 75 mm. So one module of rat trap bond consists of 3 bricks, first brick, second brick and the third brick, okay. So 250 for the shiner face and 75 for the roll-up face, which is 325 mm, okay, 325 mm for one module of rat trap bond. So we need to construct a wall for 3.9 meter. 3.9 meter is nothing but 3900 mm, okay. Divided by 325, we'll get the answer as 12 sets. So 12 sets of bricks are used. Each set consists of 3 bricks, so 12 sets will consist of 12 into 3, that's 36 bricks. So 36 bricks are required for constructing this wall. Also, we'll carry on with the next question. This is a bit simple question. A hemispherical earth mound of 3 meter diameter is proposed to be constructed in a children's park. The proportion of soil and sand is 3:2. Estimate volume of soil. Okay, so we have an hemisphere whose diameter is 3 meter. Okay, so volume of an hemisphere is, volume of a sphere we know that, 4/3 πr³. So volume of hemisphere will be half of this value. Okay, we know the radius, diameter is 3, so radius will be 1.5 meter. So solving this, we will get an answer, let's consider for now as x. So the soil and the sand are given in the ratio 3:2. So total parts I have 5, and we have to find the volume of soil. So this is soil, this is sand, okay. So soil is nothing but 3 out of 5 parts, and we got the volume as x. So 3 out of 5 into x will give me the answer in meter cube for volume of soil required, okay. Please let me know in the comment section if you have any doubt regarding any of the questions. Okay. So we will be carrying out with GATE 2015. This question is very similar to the question we solved in 2019 about that power shovel making 1.8 meter cube of excavation. So please try this question yourself and let me know the answer in comment section. If you are unable to solve, please let me know. I'll definitely make up in the next video. Okay. So now continuing with the next question. The number of standard cement bags required to prepare 1400 kg of concrete in ratio 1:2:4 mixed by weight batching. See, here comes the twist. Here they have asked weight batching. So we need not use this factor 1.54 because 1.54 is for volume batching. Okay. So 1:2:4 is nothing but M15 concrete. So I have 7 parts. So 1 kg of cement used will give me 7 kg of concrete. Therefore, for obtaining 1 kg of concrete, I will use 1 by 7 kg of cement. But we need 1400 kg of concrete. So 1400 kg of concrete, I will require 1 by 7 into 1400. That is nothing but 200 kilograms of cement I will need in order to produce 1400 kilogram of concrete. But they have asked the number of cement bags. One bag consists of 50 kg, so 4 bags will consist of 200 kg. So the answer is 4. Okay, it's also a very simple question. Please visit my first video regarding estimation. It's all about cement. Okay. Now we'll be seeing the last question of this video. A 15 meter long and 3 meter wide driveway. See, this is a driveway of 15 meter long and 3 meter wide. Okay. 15 meter long, 3 meter wide. Has to be paved with 300 mm x 300 mm square tiles. Okay, we are using square tiles of 300 mm x 300 mm. Okay, if each packet contains 30 number of tiles, then number of packets to be procured are. See, we have to find number of packets that are required. So 15 meter is nothing but 15 into 1000 mm. 3 meter is nothing but 3 into 1000 mm. Okay, so 15 into 1000 into 3 into 1000, this is the area of the driveway divided by area of a single tile. Okay, 300 into 300. So this equation will give me the number of tiles. Okay, this will go by 100. Okay, this will go by 10. Again solving this, and 10,000 divided by 215 will give me 500 tiles. Okay, see, if each pack contains 30 number of tiles, so number of packets will be, divide this by 30, it will be 16 3 48, it will be 16.6 packets. Okay, so 16.6 packets of tiles are required in order to pave this entire driveway. Okay, so this was all about this video. So we have solved the previous GATE questions up till 2015. I have PDF copies only up to 2007. So if you have any doubts beyond those papers like 2006-5, please let me know in the comment section. I'll definitely solve it up for you. Okay, thank you for watching this video up till end. So if you like this video, please hit the like button and please subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss out on new videos. Thank you.
Thank you.